Oh, yeah, that was a crazy fight.
That was fight of the year that year, 2010.
I watched Juan Diaz. I was in the fight
center.
That's when he walking into the crowd. Juan Diaz was there.
Damn, yeah, it was in Houston, too.
In Houston, yeah, I was there. And then I walked in when he fought Paul Malignaggi, too.
Hey, you remember Paulie's meltdown after the fight?
Yeah, he said he got robbed. I hate Texas, man.
He was saying that shit like that.
You gotta watch it. It was good. It was classic.
Yeah, he went wild. Yeah, because he thought he won. It was a close fight. You know what I'm saying?
He said if you want to get effed up, get a decision in Texas, something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, his brother was gonna get beat up. I remember some dudes were gonna mop up his brother. One of his dudes, talking all that East Coast shit that.
Man, get the fuck out of here.
Then he beat the
brakes
on him, dog.
Yeah, that was a crazy fight.
Yeah, they fought three men. I think he hit Diaz on the top of the head, and he just fell back. I was like, damn.
Yeah, I remember shit. I was little as hell. I think I fought in the amateurs that day, too.
That was 12 years ago?
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
I'm gonna ask Elie, man.
Ask him any trivia in boxing. I've seen it.
I felt a little sad when I seen that you were at the RGBA like the first time. I was like, damn, I missed them.
Oh yeah. I'm gonna go back out there. I'm gonna
Thursday 12 if everything's cool with everybody.
San Antonio, they've had how many world champions? Four, five.
This just became the fifth.
Fuck, he knows his shit. How do you know?
I don't think Ayala, that's where I started boxing. Ayala didn't win. He went to prison.
Yeah, you know that's where I started boxing at. His gym, Sarsamona Street Gym.
Yeah, he went to prison.
Who are the champions from San Antonio?
Is John Michael Johnson?
No, what's the Jesse James Leha, right?
Yeah, that's another one. Jesse James Leha, John Michael Johnson, Robert Quiroga.
And a kid that just won the 140.
That was the first world champion, Robert Quiroga. And then there's Mario Barrios that was 140. And now Joshua Franco.
And then Hector Tanajara. Yeah.
And then I'm about to be next.
And then bam.
Yeah. You got to stay focused, man. Don't win the title and start losing focus, though. Because you know how motherfuckers do it. They start winning shit. Start getting big headed and getting on a party. And let all the party and get to them like they ain't never partied in their life.
Yeah, that's where you got to go harder, huh?
Hey, but Bash, on the way to Vegas... Check this out. I was telling Hector I gave him 1,001 business ideas for him to do after boxing. What would you recommend him to do once he makes some money, honestly?
Well, I invested in real estate. You know, man, that's what I did.
Especially in Texas.
I ran in real, get little fixer-uppers, make some money, rent them out, and they're going to get money forever. You know what I mean? Even when you retire, you get money forever, man.
Hell yeah.
But don't buy a bunch of jewelry and shit, like a couple of boxers that we know. Don't buy, spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on jewelry because it loses value. As soon as you buy it, the value goes down.
Appreciates.
It touches your neck.
Hey, I saw Walmart. He was showing me. Did you see this? Walmart is doing fake jewelry of famous rappers.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's crazy. People are funny, though. People are pretty simple-minded. You tell them. You know what I mean? Put some jewelry on you. They think they're gonna go crazy. They're all horny. It all comes to horniness, dog. They want to be this. They want the money to get girls. They want to get dressed up to get girls. Everything they do is for girls because they're horny, dog. Everything, make money so I can buy this to get girls.
Yeah, that's facts.
This,
but you don't need to. All you have to have is a good mouthpiece, right?
Yeah, you gotta just get your plan right. Get your money right. Win a couple of titles, go out without getting beat up somewhere, don't end up like Roger Taylor or those people like that who are concussed drunk, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Is Roger Taylor still alive, Ellie?
Yeah, he texted me the other day.
Okay, but he's still concussed drunk?
We texted. We didn't talk on the phone. Meldrick Taylor. His cousin's a rapper. His nephew's a rapper. He was sending me his music.
Okay. Yeah, that's a great guy. He had the skills to beat everybody. The one fight changed his whole life, dog. And he used to slur his speech.
He was never the same.
You gotta look that up, man. Look up Meldrick Taylor against Julio Cesar Chavez.
Nah, yeah, I remember it, and I remember seeing interviews after his speech was all messed up.
Yeah, dog,
you're
so yeah.
Hey, listen, tonight.
Your business, man, and make good investments, and you'll be
alright. Appreciate you, Bash.
For sure. Alright, Bash, man, we'll talk tomorrow for sure, and then I'll let you know tomorrow about Thursday if everything's cool.
Yeah, Thursday I'll come too. Say what's up.
Sounds good. All right,
y'all.